Dear friends and followers, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be talking about a question I have received ever so often. Joe, how do pilots steer the plane on ground? That is a great question, so let's get started.
1383, runway 27, clear to take off. United 1538, runway 27, wait.
Okay, let's quickly look on how a little Cessna or a Piper Cadet steers around the apron to get to the runway. The nose wheel on a Cessna is mechanically connected to the rudder pedals, which you use to move the rudder attached to the vertical stabilizer. But the nose wheel only moves by a few degrees. So if you wanted to perform a 90 degree turn to enter a taxiway, for example, you would apply a brake pressure on either side of the main landing gear and use the propeller airstream to more or less pull yourself around the corner. The disadvantages obviously are tyre abrasion and a lot of stress on the nose wheel strut. So airplane manufacturers had to come up with an idea. Now, using asymmetric thrust would do the job, but the torsion forces on the nose wheel strut would severely damage the construction. So again, the nose wheel is linked to the rudder pedals like in your little Cessna, but another additional mechanism was installed, the so-called nose wheel steering, which is powered hydraulically. You could compare it like your power steering in your car. Now, next to your side stick, you have this little tiller, which you can turn left and right. So let's imagine you've just vacated a runway and you have to make a few turns from one taxiway to another. As you turn the tiller, hydraulic fluid is forced into this cylinder. Within the cylinder sits a cog rail, which can be moved in either direction depending on your input. The cog rail passes along a cog wheel, which is directly connected to the nose wheel. So as you move the tiller to either side, you more or less control a valve which opens up and hydraulic fluid pushes the cog rail, which turns the cog wheel and then turns the nose wheel. Now the maximum deflection you can apply with the tiller is 75 degrees, which is ideal for turning into the gate position or lining up on the runway. But as you perform your takeoff roll, the tiller inputs become smaller with increasing speed. You then transition from the tiller to the rudder pedals to steer the aircraft on the runway, as they are also interconnected with the nose wheel steering. The maximum deflection is 6 degrees to either side. And again, with increasing speed, the possible deflection angle gets less and less until reaching a speed of 130 knots, where the nose wheel steering is then deactivated and you maintain the plane on the runway centerline by using the rudder of the vertical stabilizer, as the speed is high enough to control the plane with aerodynamic forces. As you lift off, the nose wheel then fully extends and slips into a centering cam, which centers the nose wheel before it gets retracted and stowed. Now, as you know, airplanes need to be pushed back out of their gate position, and in order to do that, operations will send you a pushback truck, which either will lift up your entire nose wheel or is connected via a push bar at the front of the nose wheel. Now, either way, the pushback driver has to insert a so-called steering pin. As soon as the pin is inserted, the nose wheel then can move freely to either side by a maximum of 95 degrees. As it is then disconnected from the hydraulic system, because as you commence pushback, you also start your main engines applying hydraulic pressure to the system. Now, once the engines are running, you have to perform a flight control check, including the rudder of the tail fin with the pedals. And as you can do that check during taxi, your plane would swerve back and forth during your rudder check as the pedals are connected with the nose wheel. To avoid that, you press the nose wheel steering disconnect button, which deactivates the linkage to the rudder pedals, but you can still use the tiller to maneuver your plane during the flight control check. It's fairly simple, to be honest. So let's recapture. You can steer the nose wheel by either using the steering tiller on either sides of the pilot's side stick until reaching 80 knots, or the rudder pedals until reaching 130 knots, and there's one more option, the autopilot. As you come in for an autoland landing, after touchdown, the autopilot controls the nose wheel to maintain the runway centerline by using the signals of the ILS localizer antenna. So once you reach taxi speed, you disconnect the autopilot and the auto brake system and use either the rudder pedals or the steering tiller to vacate the runway. Now, how do you know as a pilot if you're on the taxiway line? Now, the perspective from the cockpit onto the taxiway is pretty good as you are sitting relatively high. So as long as you have the perspective that your vertical axis of your body is in line with the taxi line, you're spot on. Or if you can feel a bump every now and then, your nose wheel has just rolled over a taxiway light which is embedded into the tarmac. And to be online at your gate position, you either have a marshaller guiding you with hand signals or, if available, via the AVGDS, the Advanced Visual Docking Guidance System. To sum up, the nose wheel steering system is a great help to steer and navigate the plane around long taxi routes, lining up on the runway and to enter the gate position. But the minor the inputs, the better and smoother it will feel for the passenger whilst taxiing. And by the way, the Boeing 777 can also move its rear axle of the three on the main landing gear to perform closer turns, reduce tire wear and stress on the structure, so it's similar to a bulldozer. So that was it for today. I hope you enjoyed the short video about the nose wheel steering on airplanes. Make sure to perform a touch and go at my Instagram account. The link is in the description below. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you won't miss out upcoming videos. See you next week. All the best, your Captain Joe.